Hi, this is a little excerpt from Diary of a Mad Seamstress. This is me, Sue. You can't see me. Peace, yay. But anyway, this is me. Just wanted to touch base on a alteration type thing, embellishment I was doing here. Friend of a friend has got this bag. The shoulder strap mid-seam is inside here. Sorry, you can't see it. I decided to do this after I'd already gotten started on the project. I reinforced it. There's two layers of this. It's sewn around two times. It's locked in. It's not coming apart. The fabric's soft to the touch. It's nice and smooth. It'll do the job. It'll be great. It looks okay. The button loop was still attached and fine, yes. The button itself was gone, so I have replaced that with a nice, heavy-duty, solid metal button. Obviously, it's been gone through a few times. I've wrapped it very securely. It is not coming off. Dum-da-dum-da-dum. So, there. See? Ta-da! Then I was also asked to embellish the flowers on the front in a quote-unquote rethread kind of way. So the flowers all started out looking like this, with the same solid embroidery stuff that you can see under here in the middle, and that was it. I've added solid, I don't know, I think they might be copper, I have no idea. These little sequin things, they're really thick and really sturdy, and they're not bending very easily. They came off a belt. I put these on here. I've put on the amber glass beads that you see. And then on the middle one, I took the flower off a pendant necklace, and I started to add more of the beads on, and I was getting really close to completion, and then I turned the bag over. For some bizarre reason, I turned the bag over, and I discovered this. So, being me, I was not going to send the bag home with the shoulder done, the button done, and the beads done, just to have the bottom of the bag fall out on said person. So, I slashed it here, and went on in, and we'll turn it inside out, and we're going to take a look at it for just a moment. Okay. I would like to do this video without saying bad words, so I'm going to say this could have been done better by a drunken chimpanzee. How's that? A really severely drunken chimpanzee. When you're working with stuff that involves a circle, surging is just a basic, isn't it? But okay, so enough of my griping and looking at this like, well, you used cheap fabric and you treated it like it was cheap fabric and you've sold it to somebody who is associated with somebody I know and care about, and so I think that whoever you are who actually made this and sold this, you're a big bonehead. I'm going to fix this now. And then they're also going to be getting their bag not only fixed in the direction they thought they wanted it fixed, but they're going to get it completely fixed in the direction I would like to hand it over, because I can't hand this over and actually do that in a clear conscience. It won't work. I won't function well. So what we're going to do is we're just going around here. We're going to serge up all this frayed junk. We're taking it in to at least the edge that was already sewn. I'm getting all this extra junk that isn't accomplishing anything off of here. We're going to neaten all of this up by doing it. And the serge stitch should lock most of this in place so that it is a little easier to maneuver on a standard machine, which will do the last stitch that we need. And then I can get back to finishing up the beading and not have this nightmare on my brain. in here where I can see the most pulling apart and damage and stuff, I'm just going to pull this down so it meets better than it was, because it wasn't at all. Okay, so, ta-da, we have serged it. Now, turn it around, look at it, make sure everything that we wanted to have... God, ...is in there and done and stuff like that. Oh! This is a nightmare in sewing. That's what it is. It's a nightmare in sewing. Okay, you can see right here, it's still not right, so we're just going to take that in a little bit more. And that's done just by pulling this over this way a little bit more, on this side here, okay? The bad stuff gets cut off, and what's left of the good stuff gets sewn back together. Not going to hurt us to go over it. Plus, if I see something that's still loose on this side as I'm going around, I can take care of it right then and there. Right back where we started at the beginning. So now we've moved over here and we're at the standard machine. And we're just going to do a straight stitch right around the inside of what we did with the serger. Go forward a little bit, go back, lock it in that way. And then I'm just keeping the edge of the fabric right here along the edge of the presser foot, okay? It keeps it right inside the seam line of the serger, so the black thread that I had in there, because I did not have the time to change that. One of these days, I'll have a clone and I'll have lots more time to do things like that. And if you're wondering what I'm doing when I stop, I keep pulling this layer here, that is the stand-up part of the bag, around so that it doesn't wrinkle and catch and get all bumpy and lumpy when I stitch this seam. I'll show you when I'm done with the seam, and then you'll see what I'm talking about. Sorry, folks. I have a lack of room issue, which means I get extraneous noise that drives me nuts. Along with everything else. And along with not having enough room. So there. We've made it all the way around. We've locked it in. Here. Now, happy clones. And I will trim off the excess, because I don't like those weirdos from wherever the hell this thing originally came from. And, aha, there we go. Now we turn it right side out. And look, all the way around the bottom, sewn much better. Serged, made nice. All the other seams, made nice. Okay, it's not going to come apart. The serge helps to keep it locked. It's called an overlock. Look, the machine is known as a husky lock. Yeah. All for good reasons. Yahoo. And look at that. Not my stitch. Okay, we'll fix that too. And then we're closing the inside of the bag up. Jeez. So much fun to sew other people's stuff. Anyway, so next time you actually want to have your stuff fixed, you buy something somewhere, someone gives you something somewhere, you go on vacation, you buy something from some third world country person, no offense, look at it. Make sure it's actually going to hold up to what you're going to do in a week. Because this is really shoddy workmanship that I'm looking at here. And I hate to tell people that, but that's exactly what I'm looking at. It's badly made, and there's so much to fix. And I did not know there was this much wrong with it, and I'm not going to get paid to fix all this. So please, stop buying junk. Buy something worthwhile, worth you, worth my time. Because this isn't. Ready? This was a ReThreads bag, it would never have made it back to my sewing machine. Anyway, so, next time, do me a favor, please, just buy my stuff, because this is so silly. Thanks, and have a terrific day, and recycle.